Welcome, viewers, to Wisdom One-on-One with me, your host, Pastor Wesley Manasseh. I pray you have been enjoying this series about sharpening the axe of your mind. Imagine, when your mind is sharpened, it becomes an axe that can cut through any tree. It can cut through any environment. Imagine there's a way you can sharpen your mind, that your mind can bring you anything you want. 2022 is coming. We're wrapping up this year. 2022 is coming. Are you sharp enough to take advantage of 2022? Have you sharpened your... You see, you must use the end of the year, December. Use it for reflection. Don't have a year finish like this. And a year is finishing. And imagine all you are doing is, you start getting excited again. Anyway, 2022 will be my year. But I thought 2021 was your year. Listen, if you don't sharpen the axe of your mind, you'll be repeating things. Years will be coming and going, and you will not produce the way you're supposed to produce. If you don't sharpen the axe of your mind, imagine 2021 is gone. Gone, literally. You're looking at a year that is finished. But at the beginning of 2021, we had the resolutions. I want this. I want to achieve this. I want this. I want this. Now, 2021 is finishing. We're in December. Have you reflected how what has happened? Because having a sharpened mind, we're talking about sharpening the axe of your mind. The mind is the axe that you use to cut through life. Now, we are looking at, if you have a sharpened mind, meaning you've sharpened the axe of your mind, you are supposed to look at 2021. The whole month of December, use it. Let me give you my syllabus, what I do. December is for two things only in my life: Thanksgiving and thinking. That's what I do the whole month of December. I thank God for every day, every month, every week, for the whole year. I thank Him for 1 month continuously. Every time I'm alone, I pick a song and I sing to Him. I open my lips and I say, Daddy, thank you. Thank you. 2021 has been exceptional. 2021 has been awesome. Constantly. And constantly, I take time out, I think. This year when it started, I wanted to achieve things. What have I done? When this year started, I wanted to do things. I set these goals. Where am I on the goals? When this year started, I said, I must achieve this, I must do this. What have I done? How many of those things have been achieved? How many are in the pipeline? How many am I going to achieve before 31st December? Because I still have a good number of days. So December is supposed to be used for reflection. It's supposed to be used for you asking questions. What worked in 2021? What did not work? A person who has sharpened the axe of their mind is constantly critical and analytical of each day, each week, each month. A year has gone. What have you achieved? A year has gone. What have you invested in? A year has gone. Where did you succeed? Where did you fail? A year has gone. What worked for you in 2021? What didn't work for you in 2021? A year has gone. Are you able to reflect? Listen, I learned this from God, and that's why, if you want to learn about success, study God. The Bible says at the end of every day, God will see what He has done and He will say, this is good. At the end of 6 days, when He finished everything, He saw what He had done and says, this is very good. So God has got a system of monitoring and evaluating. When I started in the morning, at the beginning of the day, there are things I wanted to do. There are things I wanted to achieve. At the end of the day, have I achieved what I set out? We learned that from God, Genesis chapter 1. So God would see, after the end of the day, He sees, okay, yeah, this is good. I wanted to create the heaven and the earth. Okay, I wanted light. Okay, I wanted the day and the night. Okay, yeah, this is good. I've achieved what I wanted to achieve in the day. This is good. So you must look at every month. You must look at the whole year. Has this year been good? Okay. Are you able to evaluate like God to see, when I set out at the beginning in January, this is what I wanted to achieve. This is what I wanted to do. This is where I wanted to be financially. Spiritually, I said I want to be here. Relationships-wise, I wanted to achieve this. You look at all those things according to where you are and what you want to achieve and where you're going, and evaluate. Have I achieved? That's what a person who's sharp does. Do you know what a person who's not sharp does? A year finishes like this, they don't evaluate. They just say, okay, certain things happened, certain things didn't happen. Anyway, God knows. Then they go into 2022. 2022 finished in 2021. Again, at the end of the day, they say, you know what, God knows. These things, you can plan, but you don't know. No. God, who knows, him, he looks at his day and he says, this is good. Yes, this is right. Yes, this is what I want to achieve. That's God, who you are saying he knows. He values, he evaluates, he monitors, he sees, I set out to do A, B, C, D. Yes, I've achieved A, B, C, D. You are watching this program right now. You are supposed to evaluate 2021. I set out at the beginning of 2021 to achieve things. I had goals, I had targets. End of 2021 has come. What have I achieved? What stopped me from achieving? Where did I make losses? Where did I make profits? Listen, if you don't do what I'm telling you, you are the same person in 2022. Only a person who understands what I'm talking about will become a sharper person, a better person in 2022, and they'll get better results. Why? You cannot change the year, but you can change yourself. I've said something very important. When you read Ecclesiastes, I think let me read this to you so that you get this wisdom. We are talking about sharpening the axe of the mind. I want you to see, Solomon begins to bring out things that a lot of people don't get when he's bringing them out. Ecclesiastes chapter 1, verse 3 coming down. What do people gain from all their labors at which they toil under the sun? Listen, generations come and generations go, but the earth remains forever. Listen, the sun, verse 5, Ecclesiastes chapter 1, verse 5. The sun rises and the sun sets and hurries back to where it rises. The wind blows to the south and turns to the north. Round and round it goes, ever retaining on its course. All streams flow into the sea, yet the sea is never full. To the place the streams come from, there they return again. Now, listen. Here is a man. He's talking about a system. He says, the sun will rise, the sun will go down. Says the wind will blow and it will disappear. It will blow again. So what I'm trying to say and bring out here, this is the wisdom I'm trying to bring out. If the sun comes out today and the sun beat you, the heat was so much. Hey, me, I walk a long distance. This heat is affecting me. And tomorrow you wake up and still the sun beats you. There's something wrong with you. That's what I'm bringing out. Why? You know the sun will come out. The same way 2021 has ended, 2022 will end. So if the sun beat you today, tomorrow, why can't you get an umbrella? So that tomorrow the sun doesn't beat you. What are we doing in December when we're thinking? We're trying to come up with ways of getting an umbrella, so that the sun that beat us in 2021 doesn't beat us in 2022. That's why we think. That's why we ask questions. We are trying to protect. We are trying to become better. We are trying to become sharper. If you don't create time to think, I guarantee you, you will produce the same results in 2022. And life is just going to be the same for you. Oh, just the same. Every time I do something, after I am done with it, I review it. Okay, where did I go wrong? Okay, what did I do? Okay, what is this? What is it? I review it. And imagine every time I'm doing, whether I'm working on a project, every project I do, I become better, I become smarter. Why? Because at the end of every project I review, okay, I did this. This is what I encountered. This was the hurdle I faced. Okay, I did this, but this is what has happened. I did this. This is what has happened. What did I miss? What did I not miss? So that if I can get the right stuff, I will know I'll do it better. I'll do it more efficient. I'll do it more excellent. And I am going to get better results. And guess what? It will make me succeed. It will make me profit. And it will make me go ahead. Sharpening the axe of your mind is about sharpening the results that you get. Looking at everything you do and asking, is it according to my standard? Is this what I want out of life? Is this the results I want to get? Is this where I want to be? When you have a sharpened mind, you have sharpened the axe of your mind, you question things. You don't just accept things. You question things. You think through things. As you are questioning things and thinking through things, guess what's happening? Wisdom, light. That's what the prodigal son did. The prodigal son said, I'm trying to eat pig's food. But in my father's house, there are servants who have food to spare. Pig's food, food to spare. Pig's food to spare. Food to spare is good now. So I'm dropping pig's food. And he came to his senses. If you don't think this December, nothing is changing in 2022. Doesn't matter who's your papa, doesn't matter who prophesies over you. If you don't think in this, you don't think, hear me, the life will be the same. You know, I went to get something. Just yesterday, I went to get something. And this person began to open up about the abuse she has gone through by the prophetic. It really hurt me because I'm a pastor and she's talking there and you hear how she has been abused, taken advantage of, and she doesn't know, she's lost. And I'm there, I'm saying, this thing has to come to an end. People have to think. You need to think. You need to question things. Don't just swallow everything. Even me, as I teach you things, question. You see, the goodness with what I teach is I teach principles. I teach fundamentals. I will give you the liberty to question what I teach. Scrutinize it. Why? It's a principle. You will go anywhere, you still come back to the principle. What I'm telling you, if you don't think, go to anyone to prophesy on you, go to anyone to declare on you. Next year, you'll still end up like this year. Pastor Manasseh, what do you mean? You are now a prophet of doom. No. You see, you love being spiritual sometimes without understanding. I thought this year you received a prophecy. I thought you had a word this year. What happened? If you don't change, the word doesn't come. Look at it. Elisha gave a prophecy. By this time tomorrow, there's going to be food for everyone. Good prophecy. Some said amen. Actually, one person said, even if God opens the windows of heaven, where will that food come from? And the prophet heard and told him, you will see it, but you will not eat of it. But look at what happened. Four lepers said, why sit here and die? A prophecy came, but only people who had a question are people who activated the result. A prophecy, a declaration was made. By this time tomorrow, food will be short for a shekel. This and this for a penny. Do you know that only four lepers sat at the gate and they began questioning life? Everyone who heard the prophecy and didn't do anything couldn't move. But people who began asking questions, why are we sitting here? If we sit here, we die. If we go in the city, we die. If we go in the camp of the Assyrians and the Arameans, we might die, we might be spared. Now look at how thinking does, what it does. Look at where the way thinking and working with a sharpened mind does. If I sit here, dead. If I go in the city, dead. If I go in the camp of the enemy, I can be killed, I can be spared. 100% death, 100% death, 50-50. Do you know that even a person who doesn't have common sense knows that 50-50 is better than 100% death and 100% death? But where did that solution come from? Thinking, why sit here and die? You want to have a sharpened mind, you need to be a questioner. You need to ask questions. Why am I suffering? Why am I broke? Why am I poor? Why do I have a small car? Why am I walking? Okay, why don't I go for holiday? Why aren't my children happy in my house? They go into other people's houses. They are more happy to go to Nyumba ya neighbor than Nyumba Mwanga. You see, if you don't ask these questions, your poverty continues, your situation continues, your stagnation continues. It is when you begin to ask questions and you are truthful, don't lie to yourself. Me, I remember Pastor Jolomi asked me a question. I took him to a site that I was working on and he asked me a question, said, Wezi, what do you see? And I told him, I see this project be done up to roof level, put the roof and everything. Then he told me to say, you're not finishing the project. I said, no. I was looking at the project based on what was in my pocket. And he told me something. Wezi, there is no scarcity with God. That scarcity is in your mind. I've never forgotten that statement. Listen, Wezi, there is no scarcity with God. That scarcity you are talking about, that you don't have money to finish this project, is in your head. Because some of you hear me say the things that I say and you get offended instead of being challenged to say, why is he saying this? Because look at what happened to me. When Pastor Jolomi challenged me and told me, Wezi, that scarcity is in your head. Do you know that if I was the average Zambian, the way Zambians think, I was like, no, I'm setting Mdala and Ivo. I'm going to tell you, I'm going to lose scarcity in my head. Oh my God, Zambians. No, queer. What do? I remain useless. I remain stuck. Do you know that night I went home? My wife, my daughter went to sleep. I sat in the TV room asking, why did that man tell me that scarcity is in my head? There's no scarcity with God. Why did he tell me? I sat for I don't know how long that was, but at midnight going to 01, my mind opened. The heavens over my head opened. Listen, people, I hit gold. One man challenged my thinking apparatus. He challenged this mind to say, Wezi, the scarcity is here. You are broke here. You are limited here. And when I sat alone in everyone, you must have alone moments. Jacob wrestled with an angel alone. The first time he had an encounter, a ladder came up. Angels ascending and descending. He didn't know it. He woke up and said, this is the place of the Lord. God is here. He anointed the rock. He missed it. Second time it happened, he told the angel, I will not leave you until you bless me. Meaning, when you miss it the first time, don't miss it the second time. You might have missed 2020. You might have missed 2021. 2022, you are not missing it. Why? I am not letting you go until you bless me. You need to hold your mind captive. This mind, imagine everything you see has been produced by this mind. This mind, you are letting it sleep. You are making your mind lazy by watching it, by allowing it to watch TV. Look at the way you watch football uncontrollable. Look at the way you watch movies uncontrollable. Look at the way you enjoy entertainment and having fun, but you don't enjoy thinking. You don't enjoy asking questions. You don't enjoy challenging your mind to produce. Yes, it will hurt. Yes, because when something has not been used, when you start using it, that friction of not operating, when it starts operating, you feel the pain. Yes, you have headaches, but hear me, when it starts working, do you know that night when my mind started working, I forever settled in my heart, I will never suffer. Why? The mind is working like a machine. I am going to go into realms that very few people have gone into. Why? Because someone challenged me. Someone told me, where's the scarcity? The poverty is in your mind. You're watching this program right now. You're saying, Pastor Manasseh, 2021 has been hard. 2021, things have not been easy. Coming from 2020, 2019, with the COVID, do you know that people have become millionaires in COVID time? Do you know that people are becoming billionaires in COVID time? Do you know that this same time, people are making turnovers that are crazy? Let me ask you this. COVID or no COVID, where did you ever see Angry Lion no customers? You're talking about COVID. You're crying about COVID. When did you ever see ShopRite not having queues or people? So you mean Angry Lion and ShopRite are not affected by COVID? What am I saying? They have sharpened their axe of their mind. They've come up with a product. They've come up with a service that Zambians have bought in. And Zambians have become slaves to the value they have created. What are you doing watching ShopRite and Angry Lion run away with all the money? What are you doing watching? You say you're a Zambian. You say you're an African. What are you doing watching? And they are running away with all the money. Do you know why I'm speaking to you the way I'm doing? The mind has to start thinking. This December, you need to awaken the giant. There's a giant hidden in you, but you need to awaken him by thinking, asking questions. What can I do? What business is there? What opportunities are there? There are opportunities everywhere, but only people who have a questioning mind ask them. Do you know that people, oh my God, when I read the Bible, God did not use people who didn't have questions. The four lepers, why sit here and die? God uses them. Don't forget, you see, when you read the Bible, read it carefully, don't rush. The four lepers went, they found the Assyrian camp, everyone had run away. They took things, went and hid. They took gold, they went and hid. They took, at the end, they said, you know what, God will strike us. But do you know that the Bible didn't say they retained what they took? The three trips they made, I think they made 2 to 3 trips, they made of gold, silver, the precious stones, the food, everything they took. Do you know those things were theirs? Because they are the ones who questioned. Do you know that anyone who starts something is the one who takes the big share? By the time everyone else comes, look at the shawarma. In Zambia, shawarma took over like wildfire. But do you know the people who made money are people who managed to make the shawarma first? Don't forget, the shawarma secret was in the sauce. That garlic sauce. That's the secret with the shawarma. The one, and the people who made it, they didn't share that secret. So they made their money. By the time people were now learning the secret and learning, they had made their money. Look at Zona. I know Zona is no longer what it used to be, but do you know that Zona made their money when they came on the scene? Because there was no one sending money before the Airtel money, MTN money came in and took the market. Zona was the one doing it and they made their money. What am I saying? When you ask the questions, when you sharpen the axe of the mind, you eat top soup, you eat the first, you break through number one, you are the one who starts. You are the one who pioneers. You make your money first. And as you are making your money, look at what you do. You are thinking of the next thing. While everyone is learning what you are doing, you are thinking of the next thing. By the time everyone learns what you are doing, you have gone into the next thing. That's how people stay on top. Just teaching this, so much is coming in my heart. But hear me, this festive season, I want you to sharpen the axe of your mind. Don't just waste money shopping. Don't just waste money, oh, Christmas, I must eat. We must party. Christmas has come. Yes, reflect. How many Christmas have come? What have I done? So even this Christmas, I must do the same thing? No. How can I make money this Christmas? If everyone is shopping in Christmas, what am I selling? That's Christmas. Everyone is in the mood to buy. Everyone is in the mood to buy a gift. What gifts am I offering? What goods am I offering? Christmas festive season is a shopping season. Every company, every organization is preparing to brand, to price things, to bring lower prices, to bring, they are preparing, they are stocking up. Everyone is stocking up for Christians, for Christmas. What are Christians doing? Oh, have a breakthrough. How? The breakthrough comes, you go and buy it from people who plan. Then next year, when you're on the same level, what do you say? One day God will do it. No, God is doing it right now. As you are getting this wisdom about sharpening the axe of your mind, God is doing it right now. Because God wants you to live a blessed life right now. If you're watching this program and you've never given your life to the Lord Jesus, your mind cannot be sharpened. When you are not born again, your spirit is not alive to God. And the Holy Spirit doesn't take residence in you. The Holy Spirit is able to quicken our mortal bodies. So if you're not born again, your mind is dull. It's not as sharp as it's supposed to be. If you have never prayed this prayer to receive Jesus as Lord and Savior, I want you to pray with me. Lord Jesus, I realize I'm a sinner. I can't save myself. Today I repent of my sins. I ask that you wash me in the blood. Come into my life and become Lord of my life. If you have prayed that simple prayer in Jesus' name, you are born again. And hear me, if you are in Lusaka, locate Barak Ministries, where Barak Christian Center is, Goshen, opposite football house. Our services on Sunday is 09:30 to 11:30. I'm meeting a lot of you in the streets who are saying, Pastor, we are watching, but very few of you are making a decision to sit. If you don't have a church and you're watching this, especially those who have just prayed that prayer and you have given your life, locate Barak Ministries and I guarantee you, you have a foundation to grow with full of wisdom. God bless you. Success is determined by the wisdom that you have. If you don't have wisdom, you cannot produce success. There is a wisdom that controls a home. There is a wisdom that governs a relationship. There is a wisdom that governs communication.
You see, it's not my people are destroyed because of lack of knowledge, because they didn't get knowledge. No! You rejected knowledge.